turning moment diagram for 4-stroke IC engine. This diagram shows the turning moment diagram. Here, x-axis represents crank angle, y-axis represents turning moment, and the maximum value of crank angle 4 pi, which means 4 stroke. Here, each stroke take an angle of pi. So totally it has 4 stroke: suction, compression, working and exhaust. Now the question is, what do you understand from the diagram? This diagram clearly shows that there is a fluctuation of energy on each stroke. Apart from that, we are getting maximum positive energy only on working stroke, whereas during the suction, compression and exhaust, very minimum energy. Compared to working stroke, we can consider this as negligible. Here, the dot lines in the turning moment diagram represent area of turning moment diagram. The area represent the work done by the IC engine, because y-axis torque, x-axis theta, multiplication of these two value is nothing but work done. So work done is nothing but area of this diagram. So we can find total work done by IC engine using this diagram. That is why we draw this diagram. During the suction stroke, pressure inside the cylinder is very less compared to atmosphere, so negative loop is formed. During the compression stroke, work is done on gas, so again a negative loop is formed. During the power stroke, I mean during the working stroke, fuel burns, gas expand, so work done by gases, so a positive loop is formed during the working stroke. Again during the exhaust, which is very similar to suction. So this is the working of turning moment diagram of IC engine. Next, let us solve a problem related to IC engine. Here, a shaft fitted with a flywheel rotates at 250 rpm. So here, n is given, 250 rpm, drives a machine. The torque of machine varies in a cyclic manner of 3 revolution. So 1 revolution means 2 pi. So 3 revolution is equal to 6 pi. The torque rises from 750 newton meter to 3000 newton meter. Let us take a horizontal line of crank angle theta and a vertical line of turning moment. Now I am going to mark the angles pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, 5 pi up to 6 pi. Then turning moment starting value 750 newton meter. The torque rises from 750 newton meter to 3000 newton meter during the half revolution. So half revolution means pi. So it rises from 750 to 3000 during the first half revolution and remain constant for the following one revolution, that is from pi to 3 pi, it will be constant. It then falls uniformly to 750 newton meter during the next half revolution, that is from 3 pi to 4 pi, it will come down to 750 newton meter. Then and remain it constant for one revolution, then it will be constant from 4 pi to 6 pi. Then the cycle being repeated thereafter. So this is the one complete cycle. So this is the given turning moment diagram for the problem. Determine the power required. So subdivision 1, we need to find power. Subdivision 2, drive the machine, percentage of fluctuation of speed. If the driving torque applied to the shaft is constant and mass of the flywheel is 500 kg, which is given, and radius of gyration is 0.6 meter. So we need to find power and second subdivision of CS. So these two parameter we need to find. N given, we can find omega using 2 pi n by 60. So 2 into pi into 250 divided by 60, you will get omega equal to 26.2 radian per second. So next step, we need to find out t mean. Assume that this is a t mean line. So we are going to find t mean, but assume that this is t mean. The area above t mean represent del E. So this is del E. Basically, we are interested in del E because del E equal to I omega square CS. If I know the value of del E, I already known, omega already known, I can easily find CS. That is my second subdivision. To find del E, I need T mean. So next we are going to find T mean. So there is a logic to find T mean that we will discuss. So the turning movement diagram finally looks like this. Crank angle, turning movement, then some T mean line. This portion is hatched to represent del E. Then some notation like A, G, H, D, E, F, N, P, L, M, P, C. You can use any notation. So now I am going to find total area of this turning movement diagram. The reason to find total area, that is equal to work done. So I am going to find total area which is equal to work done. So total area O2F equal to area of this portion. O, A, E, F, then area of A, P, G, this triangle, second one. Then area of B, C, H, G, rectangle. Then area of C, D, H, this rectangle. Okay, here the rectangle value width 6 pi, height 750. So 6 pi into 750 plus the triangle off into breadth value pi, then height 3000 minus 750. Because this value is 750, so 3000 minus 750. So this is OF into OA. Next, sorry, this is OF into AG into BG. Next, GH into CH. So GH value 2 pi, then CH value which is similar to 3000 minus 750. Then finally, OF into HD into CH. So OF into HD value pi into CH value which is similar to the same value. If you reduce these values, you will get 11250 pi. Pi is a common 10, so we can take pi outside. The reason is there is a pi on other side. So this is area. Area is nothing but work done. So the formula for work done is T mean into theta. Again, maximum value of theta 6 pi, so I am applying 6 pi here. So pi on constant on both sides, so I can cancel pi on both sides. So now I can find t mean. So t mean equal to 11250 divided by 6. So t mean equal to 1865 newton meter. Now I can mark this t mean here. So this t mean is nothing but 1875. So now I can hatch this del E portion. So now I need to find del E. Before that, we solve subdivision 1. Subdivision 1 is power. So power equal to t mean into omega. So t mean value already known. Omega also we find in the given data. So 1865 into omega, you will get 419125 newton meter. This is the answer for subdivision 1. Then subdivision 2, before we go to subdivision 2, we need del E. So del E is nothing but area of L, B, C, P, which is nothing but area of triangle, rectangle, again triangle. So area of triangle half into LM into BM, then side into side for rectangle MN into BM, then third one half into NP into CN. Here the problem is we don't know the value of LM and NP. Here this is LM and this is NP. So now I'm going to find this value using ratio of triangle. So the ratio of triangle says that this is a smaller triangle and this is the larger triangle. So base of the smaller triangle LM divided by base of the larger triangle AG equal to height of the smaller triangle PM divided by height of the larger triangle BG. Now apply the values. LM unknown, AG value pi, so here it is pi, then BM, so BM equal to 3000 minus 1875, then PG equal to 3000 minus 750. So this is 1125, whereas here it is 2250. I can cancel both values, so this is 1 divided by 2. So LM equal to pi by 2, so pi by 2 is nothing but LM equal to 0.5 pi. We will multiply this term here. So LM equal to 0.5 pi. Similarly, we have to find NP. So NP, for NP we have this is a smaller triangle and this one is larger triangle. So base of the smaller triangle NB divided by base of the larger triangle HD equal to base of the smaller, length of this height of the smaller triangle CN divided by height of the larger triangle CH. Now apply all those values. NP unknown, HD equal to pi, same value 3 pi minus 4 pi, pi equal to CN. So CN value 1125, 3000 minus 1875. Again CH value 3000 minus 750, 2250. Again when we cancel we will get 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is nothing but 0.5. So multiplication of 0.5 with pi, you will get NP equal to 0.5 pi. Now we know the value of LM and NP. Now apply this value on this formula. So del E equal to, this is the formula. So I'm going to apply half into 0.5 pi into 1125 plus 2 pi into 1125 plus 1 by 2 into 0.5 pi into 1125. So here LM 0.5 pi, NP 0.5 pi. So finally del E equal to 8837 Newton meter. So del E equal to I omega squared CS. Again I equal to MK squared. Okay, so del E is 8837 MK squared omega squared CS M 500. K value applied here and omega is equal to 26.2 squared into CS. So finally this is 123559 CS. When you reduce it, CS equal to 0.07. So subdivision 2, coefficient of speed. So CS equal to 0.07. Thank you.